Russia's foreign minister has expressed a concern over the stalling of Russian aid trucks destined for eastern Ukraine that remain at the border, waiting to be let through.
Hope that delaying the safety guarantees for the Russian humanitarian convoy is not an attempt by Kiev to sabotage the aid.
Well, Kiev has accepted the convoy is indeed carrying only humanitarian aid. Maria Finoshina spoke with some of those in urgent need of this help.
Every day, Natalia wakes up while her grandchildren are still sleeping. She has to wash the clothes they wore yesterday so they can wear them again today. Three generations of the family fled their native Lugansk a month ago when shells started falling in the neighbor's backyard, and they took just a few things with them.
Напомнила.
Что осталось там?
Собаки, гуси, куры. Дом, дача, все поставалось.
The youngest, 5-year-old Yulia, doesn't fully understand her family's dire situation. But Dasha, while only 9, already has to deal with some very adult problems. The girls had a puppy. They wanted to take it with them, but it died just before they left.
Он был привит уже все и заболел. И потом, когда стреляли, самолеты летали, его не стало. Умер под кроватью на улице.
От испуга.
Сердце еще слабое было после болезни.
Their temporary shelter is a relative small country house over the border. And Yulia and Dasha spend most of the time with their grandmother now. Their parents spend their days searching for a job. So far, in vain.
Работа, садик, школа для семьи. Ну, мы пенсионеры, нам пенсию, наверное, платить не будут. Проблема пенсия, деньги где брать. Нам домой возвращаться хочется.
Сергей also left Lugansk when it became too dangerous. He was lucky and almost immediately found a job and shelter, but he's not happy about being away from home.
Когда смотришь какие-то ролики там прошлых лет, там Чечня, Сирия, Ливия, даже не думал, что это может произойти именно в нашем городе. Ну как-то даже всерьез по первому времени и даже и не воспринималось.
The families we spoke to are just two examples of the life of Ukrainian refugees, but they are just a drop in the ocean. In the 4 months since Kiev launched its large-scale military operation, the UN says more than 100,000 people from eastern Ukraine have been internally displaced. Russian officials say more than 700,000 Ukrainians from war-torn regions have crossed the border. And there are no statistics on how many of them have managed to settle, find a job, or even just a place to live.
The lives which the refugees from Ukraine are running from are horrible, but their future is bleak. They do not know whether they will ever be able to return home or if they need to start a new life here. Most are stuck between, waiting for what tomorrow will bring to their war-torn motherland, hoping that it will be peace. Maria Finoshina, RT, in the Russian-Ukrainian border.